most professors like to speak. I can't really find myself speechless. Nevertheless, very much the leadership of the Academy for this occasion, for me to celebrate my not completely end of my life, but firstly, I really want to thank my nominator, without whom this will not happen, and to the distinguished award committee and the award committee bestowing me the award upon me. Secondly, I want to thank to my immediate family and the extended family for their love and support, how they conduct themselves during our lives, give me the peace and comfort that enables me to work and pursue what I love the most, which is science and engineering. I was born in 1933 in Bratislava, at that time Czechoslovakia. My birth certificate says gender girl, religion Jewish. This was the year when Hitler was elected, I emphasize, elected to be Chancellor of Germany. I experienced the fear of Nazis, though my family was not religious. In fact, in 1978, my family converted to Catholic faith, though this didn't help to save them. My parents and all the close and distant family members were executed either in Auschwitz or in local grave yards in Slovakia. I survived because of some good Slovaks who were willing to hide me. The war brings out the best and the worst in people. As well known in 1948, Czechoslovakia became communist, and I experienced the Stalin dictatorship and oppression again. All these experiences made me who I am today. They taught me that while I love mathematics, engineering, and science in general, the most important thing in life is caring for people. I make my life mission to create the best possible environments. I know how to, for the colleagues and students to do the best science they can. This is what I try to do at the University of Pennsylvania, establishing the GRASS lab, and I continue to do so at UC Berkeley. All my work life, I worked one way or the other on robotics with the aim and belief that robots can help people. In 1972, when I began my career at UPenn, it was very clear to me that I would not be able to compete with MIT, where was Marvin Minsky, Stanford, where was John McCarthy, and CMU, where Newell and Simon were the big fathers of artificial intelligence and robotics. Unless I am creative, hence I'm motivated by a psychologist, J.J. Gibson, I started to develop an engineering version of active perception, which connected data acquisition, signal processing, and control theory. I stated, we not only see, but we look. We don't only touch, but we feel. This was genesis of the GRASS lab, which I am happy to say that today it flourishes and has grown to 100 plus members from computer science, electrical engineering, mechanical engineering, and other, speaking of multidisciplinary activity. In 1999, I moved to National Science Foundation as the director of SCiEZ, again in the spirit of serving the computer science and engineering community. After my stay at NSF in 2001, I moved to UC Berkeley as the founding director of newly formed Center for Information Technology and research in service to society. Again, the main force for me to take this position was the use of science and technology in service to society. After 3 years, I stepped down and became a regular professor teaching robotics to both undergraduates and graduate students. My current research area is using system identification methodology to have dynamic models to predict physical abilities. Once we can assess individual physical abilities, we can design assistive devices. I will conclude that I'm really happy for this award. It's a great privilege to me, but I also want to say I am a very happy and proud American and grateful immigrant. Thank you.